Okay, so I have been getting an enormous amount of requests from people wanting to know, what is wet sanding, how do you do it, why do you do it, and how do you polish a guitar? This is a personal guitar of mine, and I decided it would be a good opportunity to go into how I do my wet sanding. A lot of people are probably looking at this right now and saying, well, that looks plenty shiny, and it is. It is pretty nice. The orange peel that you get from Deft Clear Coat, which is what I use, is actually really subtle, and it gets pretty shiny out of the can. Now, I've already polished and wet sanded the headstock, and as you can see, it's much shinier, much smoother surface, looks like a mirror. You can see the lights on my ceiling fan up there almost perfectly. And it just really makes the color pop, it's smoother, it looks professional, it looks how a guitar would look out of a showroom. And that's the goal with wet sanding. The materials you'll need to do wet sanding, you need a soft surface to work on. I like to put a towel on my desk. You're also going to need a small bucket or bowl of water. You don't need a ton, but you do need to put soap in it. Not very much. Probably I use like a pump and a half or two pumps of hand soap, just regular hand soap. If you're using like dish soap, you can use just a drop or two of like the high concentrate dish soap. And that's all you need. You don't need it bubbly, you don't need it really soapy, but you do need a little bit of soap in there. If you try using just water, the sandpaper sticks and it just kind of, you know, chatters its way across the top of the surface, and it makes it a real pain to wet sand. So just a little bit of soap helps the sandpaper glide across the top. A lot of people like to use tons of different grits of sandpaper. I've heard people go from like a 320 to a 400 to a 600 to an 800, 1200, all the way up to like 3000. It's unnecessary. You don't need that many kinds of sandpaper. I use 400 grit sandpaper, and I use that to level the surface. And once the surface is leveled, I use a 2000 grit sandpaper to polish it up a bit. And using the 2000 grit, you'll actually start to see some shine. And once the entire surface is somewhat shiny, reflective, then you go through with a buffer and you polish it to look like the mirror. You're also going to want some kind of dry rag. This is just a terry cloth. Just something that you can wipe the water and everything off, because you need to constantly sand a little bit, wipe off to see what you're doing. Otherwise, you're going to end up burning through the clear coat and into the lower levels of paint. Burning through means that you've sanded past the top lacquer clear coat and you've started to sand into your lower finishes. When that happens, you're done. You need to go back, recolor it, re-clear it, do whatever you need to do, and then start over. When wet sanding the flat surfaces on the guitar, you can use a sanding block. This is a rubber sanding block. You can get it pretty much anywhere, Home Depot, Harbor Freight, wherever. And it's got a perfectly flat surface that you can use to level all the texture at once. This is pretty useful on flat surfaces like this, but under no circumstance do you want to use it for a curved edge, the sides, any kind of contours. If you're doing like a Les Paul kind of guitar where it has the arch top, do not use a block sander. You're going to burn through on the high points of the curves very fast, and it's going to ruin everything. Now on a paint job like this, I've got binding that's painted on. It's not actual binding. I've got a burst, and I've got the marble top with the candied red on it. There's a lot of paint going on the top. On the back, all it is gloss black. And because of guitar finishes like this, I always start on the back. If I burn through on the back, all I have to do is touch up the black, re-clear the back, and I can continue with my work. If I burn through on the front, I gotta start the whole thing over again. So if I find evidence that my clear coat is too thin by sanding on the back, I know to stop there, touch up my work, and put more clear on before I continue wet sanding. If I do it on the front, I'm done. So we're gonna grab our 400 grit. You just go, you don't have to apply a lot of pressure, just let the sandpaper do its work. You'll start noticing right away that you're getting this white milky residue. That's the clear coat getting sanded off. You want that. And just keep doing circles. Maybe change direction a bit. You don't want to sand back and forth. That's how you get noticeable scratches that are much harder to remove later on. It's really not that difficult. You just want to avoid putting too much pressure and putting too much effort in one area so you don't burn through or leave heavy scratches. Now my water's starting to dry up and starting to get a bit sticky. This is usually the point where I like to wipe off the surface and check my surface. You can already see that I'm starting to wet sand off some of the texture. When you have a heavy noticeable orange peel, you'll get to see easy spots where, if I can get the camera to focus, there you go, right there, you can see how there's shiny spots within the flat sanded spots. You want to get rid of all the shiny spots. You want the entire surface to look like this. That means you're done sanding. So you can already see where I need more work. You can see that there's shiny spots in places still. But that's only after about 2 minutes of wet sand. Now you can see that the whole backside is pretty much done. I'm going to move on to the top before I finish off the backside, because I'm going to do all the block sanding before I move on to the hand sanding. Now I've done all the block sanding that I feel comfortable doing, and I'm going to start wet sanding with the 400 grit by hand. And I'm going to again start in the back. Now I'm completely done doing the 400 grit sanding on the top and back. And before I get to the sides, I have a feeling that a lot of you are probably asking yourself some questions like, why am I doing wet sanding and not just dry sand? The finer grit sandpaper you use, the easier it loads up. When you're doing sanding using grits as high as 400, 600, 800, and higher, it's almost impossible to do any kind of sanding when you use it dry. The sandpaper loads up super fast. What the water does, and what the soap in the water does, is help prevent the clear coat that I'm sanding off from sticking in the sandpaper. A lot of you are probably also wondering, why don't I use like a palm sander or something electric, because this is taking forever. The answer to that is never, ever, ever, ever use an electric tool to wet sand. They can get way out of control way too fast and remove way too much clear coat. This is a very delicate process, and you need to be very careful. Constantly sand a little bit of area, dry it off, and check, because you want to remove just enough of the texture. You're also probably wondering, why don't I just submerge this in my bathtub under a couple inches of water and wet sand that way, so I don't make such a mess with the water bucket and the towel and everything. It would be a lot quicker. And it is a lot quicker. But it also destroys your guitar body. You never want to submerge your guitar body underwater for very long. There are swirl paint jobs where you have to dunk the body completely in a bucket of water. That's one thing, because you remove it real quick. But submersing the body underwater for, you know, as long as it takes to wet sand, which is probably an hour or two, that's gonna do some serious damage. Okay, so now I'm completely done with the 400 grit sanding. You can see that the whole body now looks pretty much flat black. Now I'm moving on to the 2000 grit sandpaper. now I'm completely done with the 2000 grit wet sanding. You can see that the body is actually starting to take some shine to it. Now the next step is to use some polish or rubbing compound to buff the guitar to a near finish. All you need is some car polish, a dry rag, and a spray bottle. Doesn't really matter what kind of polish. I get people asking all the time, what kind of polish do you use? It doesn't matter. Again, I'm using just the same yellow terry cloth that I was using before. And this is not carpet cleaner. This has always been on my desk in every video, and people always laugh at me. Why do you have a pet carpet cleaner on your desk? It's just an empty bottle. I filled it with water. Oh, and I also like to use these little saucer-looking, foam-backed, terry cloth disc thingamabobbies for polishing. They're easy to clean, they're easy to use, they're a good hand-shaped kind of thing, and you can go to town. A lot of people also want to know, why don't I do machine polishing? Use like a drill with a wheel in it, or something like that. The truth is, I do. I do quite a bit, but it's one of those things that I don't necessarily want to tell people to do because it's a very easy thing to screw up. It's very easy to let the polisher get away from you and run across the edge or burn through because you polished in one spot for too long. It's one of those things that you're going to want to do a few paint jobs and polish by hand to really get a feel for how thin the clear coat is before you start using electric polishing tools, because it's a good way to damage your paint job. And when you damage a paint job during the polishing process, the last part of the painting process, when you burn through then, and that just really sucks because you already finished doing your 2 hours of, you know, wet sanding. Now you got to start all over. You do have to do the edges by hand and inside the horns by hand unless you have a drill bit with a small cylindrical style polishing pad, because if you try to use the big, like sometimes I use a 10-inch polishing wheel, it's like that big, takes up the whole guitar, you can't get that in these horns, you'll end up wrecking something. So I'm going to show you guys how to polish by hand. Shake up your polish. You can put it on the body, you can put it on the pad, doesn't really matter. Put it on the pad. So that's all I'm going to use right now. Just that little bit. You start rubbing it in. Little circles help. You can do it in a back and forth motion if you want. It's not too important. You can feel when the polish starts to get chalky, it starts to dry up. That's what the water's for. The quick spurts, you don't need much. Keep going in circular motion. I haven't even wiped the polish away, and it's very shiny there. Take your rag, just wipe the polish off, nice and clean there. Boom, mirror finish.
I hate you for the sacrifices you made for me. I hate you for every time you ever bled for me. I hate you for the way you smile when you look at me. I hate you for never taking control of me. I hate you for